Just let an audience build a little bit. Oh, it's fine. If you haven't already, I know it's kind of dark. I'm sorry about it. It's getting dark. If you haven't already, please go ahead and hit that share button down there. The reason I'm going late is because I was at a meeting at the VFW here in Pontotoc, Mississippi. We made it to Pontotoc, Mississippi, by the way. Spent a lot of the day up with my sister, or at my sister's house, and then I got an invite to come to dinner down here at the VFW. So I figured that's a great opportunity to go to, so I did it. So a shout out to Stephen M. Oregon. He's the state commander down there. They're going to set up a network across the path that I'm taking between VFWs to let them all know on that majority path that I'll be walking through there and to look out for me. And they can help me out as I go, so that's pretty cool. Let's see, what else? They made a very generous donation of $100. Apparently, they just lost their liquor and beer license at that VFW, and they had some, I guess, illegal other legal issues that went on, so they ended up having to pay some fines. So they got that all taken care of, so they didn't have very much money. They said they'd probably give me a larger donation, but I didn't even ask for it. They called me up, invited me up, fed me and my mom, and then made a bigger to-do out of it than I thought they were going to. So anyway, big shout out to Post 3595 here in Pontotoc, Mississippi. They're nice people up here. So I was looking at the map, and we did skip quite a few miles getting here because of the weather and stuff, but what I'm going to try to do is get a ride back north to Corinth. Since so much of this trip that Mom and I have been on has been due south, I don't look at any mileage that I skip north and south as skipping miles, because I still have that same amount of distance I have to travel west, whether I'm up north or down south. So it's going to work out. Hi, Sissy. How you doing? Love you. The weather sucked. It's supposed to rain for the next 7 days. And my sister's boss, I guess the owner of the company, or the...
Mr. Johnson.
Mr. Johnson.
He's just a board member.
I think he's more than that.
No, he's one of the board members. There's several board members.
Okay. Mom says he's just a board member, but I think he's more than that. But anyway, he came and got us from Iuka and drove us south to here. And like I said, since it's south... And this whole Natchez Trace part of the walk with my mom was all planned secondary, and it was all off of the main course. I'm not counting any of the skipped miles on it, just because it was a north-south trip. It was meant to bond with my mother. We did that. You know, we had to skip the last 80 miles, but it was that or spend a couple $100 in a hotel waiting for the stupid rain to quit. So, the current plan is if I leave from here or if I go north and head west, either way, I'm heading west and I'm not taking away from any of the distance travel or skipped going south. So, you know, I know most of you support my decisions when it comes to taking a ride, but I know there's also a couple that are going to scrutinize everything that I do, so that's basically that. Let's see, I also wanted to mention I haven't gotten the 411 wholly on this subject, but apparently my dad mentioned something to me about how some of the other walkers that are doing similar missions to me are getting in trouble, getting scrutinized and stuff, because the money that's being donated to them is not ending up in their nonprofit. And I wanted to reiterate whatever it's called. I wanted to talk about the money that gets donated to me. You are doing that exactly. It says it right there on my GoFundMe page. I tell every person that hands me money, this money's going to help me cross the U.S. It's going to help my wife subsidize some money, some income while I'm gone. It's to help take care of my kids, my wife, and myself while I'm doing this trip. Whatever's left over at the end will get redonated. Now, if there's nothing left over at the end, nothing is going to get redonated. That's the only promise I've made about money. I'm not doing this to raise money for anybody. I'm not even doing it to raise money for myself. It just happens to be the only way I can get across the U.S. So this isn't about money. It's about awareness and spreading awareness and the growth of awareness about the 22 suicides a day. I am not taking large donations from people unless they donate it to my GoFundMe, and I just don't know until afterwards. But that money is all used to support myself, my wife, and my kids. I'm totally upfront about that. I don't want there to be any misconception that I'm collecting money for any other nonprofit. I'm not doing that. And I know most of you understand. It's just occasionally I'll get a bunch of questions about it, and then some, you know, people who kind of look at me weird. But from the very beginning, that's what I've said. So right now we're headed home from the VFW. My mom ended up walking a total of 152 miles. Probably more than that, but 152 miles on the trail that we took, the path that we took. So that's super cool. Molly's back home, or back at my sister's house, sleeping right now. I will definitely tell her that you guys said hi. But yes, as far as the money goes, you know, if people donate to me, I tell them this money is going to me buying my next lunch or my next hotel. It's not going toward helping any individuals in any other way other than me raising awareness. So I guess if you've got a problem with that, feel free to stop donating. But I know that most of you that watch me and most of you that follow me understand everything. I've been totally honest about everything I'm doing. So they said, wow, Mom, that's awesome.
Yeah, I think so too.
Good job, Mama T.
I'm
going to
join you again in the fall.
Yeah, and she's going to come back whenever I get to the Grand Canyon and walk with me some more in the Grand Canyon. I haven't decided if I'm going to actually walk the Grand Canyon Trail or not. I know I can't do it with the wagons, but maybe if we're at a, because there's a lot of buses around there.
Yeah, we could lock
maybe,
them up.
Maybe we could leave them at a hotel, take a bus to the canyon, walk it. Because
yeah.
I know that happens all the time.
Well, there's probably places close to the canyon now.
Yeah, I'm sure there is. I keep seeing that people are sharing the video. Thank you very much. Colonel Dave says that you shared. Thank you, Dave. And three other people. I appreciate all those shares. That's awesome.
I'm driving tonight, so I can't join you.
Yeah, Mom's driving right now, or she would be sharing also, and she'd be on there.
She looks funny.
No, she's not running real fast behind me. She's right here. She's driving.
Hi.
Colonel Dave said, I don't see your mom. Is she running real fast behind the car? No. You got to remember the image is flipped. Which reminds me, starting tomorrow, I'll be able to do my live videos. And the t-shirt, this is one of my new t-shirts. It's my aunt made these, or had them made and sent to me. No, none of the donation money went to this, but, you know, they're backwards, but it's a 22 and then, walk to N22, but the t-shirts that I'm going to be using for my live, broadcast from now on are actually written backwards, because Android doesn't want to get off their butt and put out an update to switch it around on the phones. So, we actually got t-shirts made up in a mirror image so that, I could do my live videos and you guys could actually read my shirts. So I think that's pretty cool. My Aunt Marie came up with that. So, generous donation. They made me sign up to be part of the VFW. Why I haven't done that already in the past, I have no idea. I should have done it before I left and kept a network going with them the whole time. It might have made some of my nights where I was sleeping in the bushes to where I didn't have to sleep in the bushes. But I signed up for the VFW. Got a check. I'm supposed to send my DD-214 or a copy of it to them, which I won't be able to do. I'll probably get Cody to look for it and do it for me once she gets home. She's going to come down and see me this Monday. We'll maybe stay a couple days, maybe a week, and then she's going to go on home, and I'll get her to send my DD-214 to an address that I've got so that I can be officially part of the VFW. It's not like they can't verify who I am. You know, all they need to do is check out my videos and call some of the people. But the DD-214 is an official part of the process, so I got to get it for them. Hi, honey. Love you. Yes, I know you told me so. So that's about it. Obviously, I can't do my push-ups tonight driving in the car. But
that's that same little lady back there.
Oh, yeah. A bunch of the wives and ladies at the VFW kind of kidnapped my mom into the other room.
Invited me to join the auxiliary.
Yep, invited her to join the auxiliary VFW, which they can do. Any family member, I guess, can do through the member, the active duty member, that or the veteran that was actually joined up. So that's cool. Cody says, "Nan and a boo boo."
Nan and a boo boo.
I love you, honey. But yes, my wife told me from the very beginning I should join up with the VFW. I just didn't because I'm lazy, I guess. I have no excuses.
Because you're a hard head.
No, to be honest, and this is the honest truth right now, I'm going to talk real talk here. Every time I go into a VFW, it stinks like cigarettes, and everybody there is half drunk. It has nothing to do with whether or not they're veterans or not, and I know they do a lot of official business. The VFW does donations, they help out local causes, they help out other veterans, I understand that. But the whole going and hanging out at the VFW is something that I'm not interested in because I don't drink and I don't smoke. And to be honest, most of the guys that I always see at the VFW are 40 years older than me. And it's just, I don't feel relatable to a lot of the guys that are there. In my opinion, you know, most of them are Vietnam vets or World War II vets, and they have a lot more experience and a lot more experience being a veteran, in my opinion. You know, I didn't do a whole lot in the war zone, but, you know, I have no idea what they did, but I never try to compare what I did to the guys back in Vietnam. I really think that they had it a lot harder. So to me, it's kind of like I drive a moped and want to join a biker gang, almost. I don't feel that I'm at that same level as those guys. But and I know that's just part of my self-doubt and all that stuff that I need to get over, which is probably why I went ahead and signed up for it today. But I don't drink and I don't smoke, so I didn't really want to, up until this point, just go hang out at a VFW. Blah, 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 blah. Molly's doing good. She's hanging out with Cosmo, which is my sister's dog, and they are best friends now. They run until they collapse, and then they drink a lot of water, and then they run until they collapse. So Molly's got a little break going, and
sleep good tonight.
She's going to sleep good tonight. I don't think she fully understands yet that I'm going to go on and she's going to stay. You know,
She knows something's
up because she won't get out of the crack of my ass. Excuse my language. But I feel bad for leaving her because she really does help me out emotionally. But I just, I feel so guilty for pushing her through the heat. Molly's foot is fine. She hasn't been limping in days. Even that last 19-mile day that me and Mom walked with her, it didn't seem to faze her. She didn't have much. She might have stumbled a couple times
when she
stepped on the gravel.
She was exhausted, but so were we.
I don't think it was her foot. But her paw seemed to be fine. I'll grab it every once in a while I'm playing with her, and I'll give it a little tweak or a squeeze to see if she favors it, and she doesn't even act like I touched it, so... hold on just a second. That's Cody. I also want to... This is just a quick little thing, a little personal thing for me. If there's anybody back in Lago or Jonestown watching, they're going to... They saved a spot for Brennan to go on the football team again this year. He's going to play football again, and I guess they're giving him the scholarship that pays for the join-up fee and the uniform and stuff. So I don't know if they did that for me or if they did that so that he could come back on the team. What? I keep hitting something down here that's turning on a light. Is it this? Yeah, it's this. But, yeah, I thought that was really great of them to do that. There's hardly any light left in here, guys. Is that gonna work? Yeah, that works a little. Let me know if that starts to bother you. But, thank you. Who said that? Elizabeth Cooper said, "Glad I made it through the fourth okay." Yeah, I didn't hear a single firework. In the hotel we were in, not one pop, not one crackle.
It was out of town.
It didn't even feel like the 4th of July, which is my ideal 4th of July, unless I'm intentionally going out to a fireworks show. I can handle the fireworks shows okay. It's just the neighborhood firecrackers that trigger me. So I'm super proud of my son. He's going to play football again. I think we may homeschool him this year. I'm not real sure how that's going to go down. I think Cody found like a homeschool co-op of some type to where the mothers all take turns doing it, or they all do it together or something. I don't know. But that way they still have the social interaction, which is the problem I've always had with homeschooling, is they don't have that social interaction. But this way they will. And that's about it. I don't really have much else going on right now. The next few days might be sparse as well, but I'm going to take lots of pictures of hanging out with my family. I'm going to take lots of pictures and videos of Cody and the boys when they get here. So stay tuned for all that. The VFW wants me to come back at least one more time before I leave town. So Cody's going to leave Indiana to come down here on this coming Monday, and I'll probably stay until the next Monday. So at least a full 7 days plus whatever's left in this week. So that'll be a good little break, and then I can start walking again. Time schedule's thrown off a little bit, but we knew from the very beginning that it probably would be. And when I'm out there by myself, I might be able to make some of that time up by doing 15-mile days, or just 12-mile days instead of 10. If I can just push it a couple extra miles a day, that after a week or so, that cuts off a couple days. So it'll catch me back up. Erin says, "Have a wonderful evening. Hopefully we can meet up before you leave town. I'm only 30 minutes away from y'all." Well, that's fine.
We're
also doing some kind of barbecue or something here for my 1,000 miles, because at my sister's house is 1,022 miles, which isn't a made-up number. It's actually, if I went my entire route and right to my sister's house, it ends at 1,022. So it's
awesome.
So it's a super awesome number. But we're going to have a 1,022-mile party. And anybody around here that watches, I'm sure, is welcome to come. We don't know when it's going to be yet. It'll probably not be this weekend, but next weekend.
We
just got here. We don't know any plans that's going on. My niece, Kristen, is trying to set something up with Tupelo or Pontotoc. They want to do something for me in Pontotoc, but we don't know what yet. We're going to try to work that out. I've got another newspaper interview with the local paper here tomorrow morning. But yeah, so if you're in the area and you want to come to the party or whatever, just, you know, give me a text message, a personal message, let me know, and I'll send you the address of where it's going to be when I know. But give me a few days, because I have no idea when and where yet, or what it's going to entail. But yeah, we'll have to have it somewhere where people aren't going to mind strangers showing up, you know.
Yeah, we'll talk to Janice.
Even if we pick a local park here,
yeah,
and go to a pavilion.
To Brenda, and we might have it down at Brenda's barn where we can drink and party.
That sounds cool.
At your brother's, we'll see.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll figure it out. It'll be cool, whatever. But anyway, that's probably it. Yeah, you can message. Yeah, okay, that's cool. But that's about it, guys. I know I'm forgetting something, but I don't know what it is. Went over the t-shirts, went over the VFW, went over... Oh, Mom walked 152 miles total. I think I did go over that already.
We can do it again.
Yeah, that's about it for tonight, guys. Yeah, call your veterans. Make sure they're safe. Make sure they're not sad. Do what you can. You know, it's hard to help somebody who doesn't want help, but you know, let people know that you're there for them. Even people that aren't veterans. If you know someone that's depressed, just let them know that you're there for them. Whatever you do, don't be that person that says, yeah, man, if you need me, just call. And then when they call, you're not there for them. Be the person that's there for them. That's about it. I love everybody.
Deuces.
Deuces. Thank y'all for watching. Bye. Call me, honey.